Well, the APC National Chairman John Odige Oyego is still our guest on Sunrise Daily this morning. Just before we went on break, I was asking you that question about the lopsidedness that a lot of people perceive the country to be in, especially in terms of federal character. Mm-hmm. And even I was giving the example of admissions, say into the federal government schools, unity schools as they're called, and even in some instances the federal universities, especially with JAMB scores. What's your response to that?
Well, it's a bit of a difficult situation. When groups come together, something must give. It is not the ideal when a group of people come together to hammer out a position. Somebody must give, somebody must take. In the situation we were in, it was necessary when the Federation started for every part of this country to have a sense of belonging. In any community, let's even get right down to Brazil, even in a village, in a community. If all the intelligent people are from one family, you cannot then hand over the affairs of the family to that community, to that group, because they are the most intelligent and you want the best for the community. There must be a way of giving so that other people, however you think inadequate they may be, to still have a sense that they are part of the driving force of that community. So on the global, on the bigger level, Nigerian level, it was necessary at that stage.
But it's still to do things now.
Yeah, it's phasing out now. We can say in this country that we have good people from virtually every part of this country. So it is something that maybe deserves to be looked at again, because I don't think there's any corner of this country where there are not good people. But the imbalances are still there, coming again from the efficiencies in our system, educational system, and the rest of it. How long it will continue, I cannot tell you. But maybe it's something that is worth taking another look at. All nations have it. The affirmative action in the U.S., all over the world. These things have happened.
It's worth taking, taking another look at. Some people will say that, but that's precisely what they were, some of the things they were hoping will change. That yes, we can take people who are, you know, from educationally disadvantaged, even though people are beginning to believe that that should have changed over the years. I mean, a state should not remain educationally disadvantaged in perpetuity, you know, but even then, it should not be to the detriment of those who have the qualifications.
No, it shouldn't. But fortunately, the educational system has so expanded. I think what is important is, let's take the principle of what you are saying. You're taking that particular, yes, it has created a lot of aggravation. I have been approached, people have approached, I got this, got that. But let us accept. It's a matter of principle. Let's accept that whenever any group comes together, you must hammer out the type of compromises. That's what democracy is all about. It's not the most efficient system of government, but it is the system that gives everybody a feeling of participation. It's inevitable. It's a principle. And we must accept that as a principle, it is what works. It is not the most efficient, but at the same time, it is the one that keeps us together.
I'm going to go again to this issue of restructuring right now. We do know that, just flowing from that report, I don't know if you listened to the report over the break, our correspondent Linda Kigbe reporting that the Senate has, you know, moved to ensure that they support the call for national unity and are asking for the 2014 Confab report to be made into a bill and sent to the National Assembly so they can look into it and see what parts, you know, how it is that they can help integrate that into the current constitution. Is it something that your party as a whole is, even though, yes, the Senate has said that, is it something that your party is considering?
The conversation has started, let me put it that way. And we cannot, as a party, ignore it. Right now, we are looking at all the options. But like I said at the earlier stage of this interview, priorities. We had a country, a nation that was supine. What was our priority? Should we face this political issue, or should we try to put bread and jobs. Provide jobs for Nigerians, put bread on their table.
People said that they took
the right choice. Hold on.
Yeah.
That does not exclude this conversation, which is, we can't ignore it. It's not possible to ignore it. So it is something we will have to address.
Mm.
And with any grandstanding that is going on, people jump on the bandwagon of populist issues. A government cannot do that. A government does not act that way. But it does not mean that behind the scenes, it is not saying, look, hold on, this thing is going on. It looks like everybody wants to talk. So maybe let's provide the opportunities to talk. We're at that stage of looking at the issues now.
Mm. Well, it's not very clear whether it's another confab they're looking at. But then
we've had too many confabs.
They're worried about the leadership of the nation right now. Yes, the acting president is in acting capacity and he's doing what he should do.
But then you can
see the different headlines as to the state of health of the president. They're worried that the APC is not saying anything about the president, who's been away for about 52 days now. Do you have any report on the current state of health of President Muhammadu Buhari?
What is there to say? We are not his doctors, but the reports we have are very good. It is a most unfortunate thing. It's not ideal. Nobody wishes that on himself or on a nation. But he's recovering very strongly.
Mentioned by the governor of Ekiti State. He says he's been on life support for a while.
That's the governor of Ekiti State. When he talks, you just discount it and move on.
Well, we have to say thank you most kindly, Mr. John Odigie Oyegun. He is the national chairman of the All Progressives Congress, and he's been sharing his thoughts with us on the state of the nation, especially as pertaining to his party's thoughts on restructuring.